One of the culinary features of the holiday of Shavuot, just like every holiday has its special food that is associated with the holiday, the feature for Shavuot is dairy. And the question arises every year, what does dairy food have to do with the holiday of Shavuot? Shavuot, which commemorates agriculturally the first fruits and the harvest of the first fruits of the season, and also historically the giving of the Torah, the Ten Commandments and the entire Torah to Moses and the people of Israel at Mount Sinai. So what does dairy have to do with that? And so there are a lot of midrashim, a lot of rabbinic commentaries and other suggestions that try to relate the idea of dairy food with the Torah. And one connection that I like involves this system known as gematria, which is the official term for every Hebrew letter has a corresponding numerical value. And there is a system in which you count up the total of the letters and you understand what the numeric value of that word is, and then you can find other words that have the same numeric value and you learn a lesson from that. So, for example, when Jacob was running away from his twin brother Esau, he lay down to sleep and had a dream of the ladder ascending to heaven with angels coming up and down the ladder. The Hebrew word for ladder is sulam, spelled there, samach lamed mem. And the rabbis make a connection that sulam and Sinai, have the exact same numeric value and teach us that what Jacob was really dreaming about was Mount Sinai. And so the gematria for Shavuot is what the word for dairy, which is really the word for milk, chalav. Chalav is chet, which equals 8, lamed, which is 30, and bet, which is 2. 8, 30, and 2 add up to 40, which happens to be the number of days that Moses was on Mount Sinai receiving the Torah. So when we eat dairy food on Shavuot, we make that connection to receiving the Torah. As we eat our blintzes and cheesecake and other delectable items, we're supposed to be appreciating the giving of the Torah and learning the Torah at Mount Sinai. I wish everyone a Chag Sameach and a meaningful Chag Shavuot.